In the first part of the series on reactive maps on Android, I shared that there are two libraries you can use to write reactive code. If you're a Kotlin developer looking to use coroutines and flows, this video is for you. The Maps KTX library contains extension functions that return Kotlin Flow objects, so you can listen to events in a reactive manner. Unlike suspending functions, which return a single value, Kotlin Flows can return several values over time. So for example, you can use a flow to receive camera change events over time. To get started using Kotlin Flows in your app, include the Maps KTX library in the dependencies section in your build.gradle file. In the previous video, I showed you how I wanted to update the map each time the user moves to a new location in my app called Old Places. To do that, I can use the callback-based API set on camera idle listener. Another way to write this using flows with the Maps KTX library is to call camera idle events on the Google Map object from within a coroutine. To start receiving events from the flow, I would then call collect, and within the collect lambda, update the UI accordingly when an event is received. In this way, the logic within collect will be executed each time the camera goes idle. The power of flows really becomes evident when you want to modify the flow using what's called intermediate operators, such as map. These intermediate operators get executed whenever a new item is emitted by the flow. In the case of map, the function you provide to it will get executed each time the flow emits an item, and the result of that is what gets passed downstream. You can chain several intermediate operators together to continue to transform the flow until you receive your desired result. Using intermediaries, let's rewrite the piece of code I shared in the first video to accomplish updating the map when the camera moves to a new position. First, let's apply a map operator and call the delay function, which is equivalent to calling postDelayed in the original implementation. We can then obtain the camera position from the map object and return that as a result of the map operator. Next, we can chain another map operator and invoke a suspending function version of the network request and return that as a result of the second map operator. Lastly, we would call collect to start receiving places relative to the new map location and update the map as a result. We've mostly covered camera move events, but other events like marker and map clicks have a corresponding flow API in the Maps KTX library for you to use to start writing code in a reactive way. I've linked in the documentation the description below so you can explore further, so make sure to check it out. Thanks for following along so far. Hopefully, you can now get started using Kotlin Flows in your app using the Maps KTX library. If you want to learn more about Kotlin Flows, make sure to check out Going with the Flow by Manuel Vivo, which gives a great introduction on the topic. So what do you think? If you have a question or suggestion, leave a comment below. And make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see more videos like this. For the next part on the series of reactive programming with Google Maps Platform Android SDKs, I'll be covering how you can use RxJava with the Maps and Places Rx libraries. I'll catch you in the next one. Yeah, practice.